So we have a question on Halachot Yom Tov. The question is like this.
Can you smoke
a candle? You have a candle and you want to light a lighter from the candle. So you're putting you have the candle and you're putting the lighter next to the candle. Yeah, you're pressing on the gas, so it's lighted from the candle. So now you have fire here, right? So now you can do whatever it is that you need to do with the fire. Now what do? If you take out your finger, so you turned off fire. You're not allowed to turn off fire, right?
Did you turn it off or did you stop making it?
Oh, so there is an opinion that I don't hold by that, and as far as I know, all the rabbis around not hold by that, but I know that there is opinion like that, that says that it is permitted. Why? Because it's like when you have a fire of wood, yeah? So you don't allow to turn off the fire, but you do allow to take out wood from the fire. So there's no wood in the fire, so the fire will turn off. But you didn't turn off the fire, you just took out the wood.
Okay. You're not obligated to keep putting more wood on.
You don't obligate to keep on putting on wood. Okay. So according to that opinion, so stopping the gas is like taking out the wood from the fire. Okay. So I know a person that he did it. I was there with him and I was like shocked, and he explained it to me that there is a pain like that, and he explained me this reasoning. But I didn't hear it from a rabbi that I'm relying on for halachot. So I wouldn't do it, okay? But if you see something like that, so there is something that you can, you know, something positive to say about it, that it's not like breaking Yom Tov, but I wouldn't count on it to do it practically. So for your question, what, like, another option that can be done is to do it with matches. Do the same thing with matches. To take the match, put it in on the flame of the candle, it turns on, and then when you finish with the match, so you just leave it without turning it off, and just match, you know, it turns off by itself when it's done, and that's fine.
What about people with gas tanks for their stoves? So they don't have an electric stove. They don't have.
Okay, so I'll tell you what I have. I have like it. I don't know like if it's possible to get it in outside of Israel, but in Israel there is something that someone came with. Something called Chag Gaz, yeah, the gaz for Chag, for Yom Tov. So what does it do? It's like a timer, but it's mechanic. It's not there's no like electric there, and you put like the time that you want that the flame will be on, put it from advance, and then you turn on the fire with like from fire to fire, right? And then you have the fire to cook with, and when the time is up. So it turns off by itself. You didn't do anything.
Like a Shabbat clock for gas.
Like Shabbat clock for gas, but you can turn it on in that moment that you want. And you want now like a coffee. So you know that it takes like 5 minutes to make coffee. So you put the watch, the timer, only for 5 minutes. And you turn it on, and it turns off by itself. Okay? So that's a wonderful idea. I don't know who is the guy, the genius guy that came up with it. But in matter of fact, I'm using it all year long, not only in Yom Tov. Because it's a good safety for the children. Instead of having the gas like open and sometimes you forget the gas and things are getting burned, right? It happens all the time. So you have a timer like that. You set it up for the time that you know that you need it to cook the whatever it is that you need to cook, and that's it. And the watch is the time is finished, and that's it. There's no gas. It's a wonderful idea. Yeah, it's a good solution. I'm using it all the time. Okay. So that's, yeah, and I don't have any percentages in the company, by the way.